Welcome back to this special holiday recipes edition of Talk of the Town. Our good friend Temi Allgood has the side dishes all figured out with ease. And that's the part I like, the ease part. All right, some good stuff here. We've got some of the appetizers out of the way, but some side dishes are very important for the meal.
That's right. And we need greens. So we're going to start out with greens for our side dish.
Okay.
So, you know, kale is like the darling of the produce department right now. So we're going to start with some snipped up kale. Mm-hmm. And what I'm going to get you to do, Leland, is just whisk those three eggs together.
Okay.
And I'm going to add some salt and pepper to that.
All right.
And some flour, okay? So that's gonna kinda hold together our greens a little bit. You just keep going. That's 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour.
Okay.
And while you're doing that, I'm going to add, this is my snipped up kale, and I'm gonna add some snipped up spinach to the kale. So if you buy spinach in this container like this, it's mm-hmm. about half a container, which is, that's about a 16-ounce container. So you're just gonna snip up about half of it, save the rest for something else. And then I'm gonna add some leeks to this.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have leeks, just use some chopped up sweet onions for this. All right, and then Leland, here's what we're gonna do. You're gonna pour that over this.
I like the consistency you want.
That's perfect.
Okay. So just pour it on top?
Just pour it on top, and what we're gonna do is just toss these greens a little bit with that mixture, and then we're gonna add some cheese to it. So the beauty of this recipe, Leland, is that if you can do it either in the slow cooker mm-hmm. or you can do it in the oven, either one. So if you've got the oven space, great, at 350. If you don't have the oven space, put it in your slow cooker.
Maybe the turkey or the chicken's in there, you need the oven for something else.
That's right. So you can do this in the slow cooker, so put it on high for about 4 hours,
okay?
All right, now we're gonna add some Gouda cheese to this, and that's what I like. It's gonna be another binder.
Uh-huh.
And then all we're gonna do is put it in our greased baking dish. If you're going in the oven or if you're going in the slow cooker, mm-hmm. put it in your greased slow cooker, about a medium slow cooker, okay? All right? All right, now, let me show you let me just do this real quick and show you what happens, because it looks like it's not gonna fit in your dish.
But it will, okay.
But it will, because what you're gonna do is mash it down.
Do they normally cook, I guess, kind of cook down, as they used to
say?
You
know how it does, but you end up with this huge pot and you get a cup full when you get through.
Yeah.
So
the
you're gonna mash it down.
Where's the fat back? Where's the ham hock at?
No, and there's not in there.
No?
It's not in there! That's somewhere else, Leland.
All right.
Okay, then when it's all baked up, see, it looks
it's gonna
like
look
it's
like
going to come down
okay.
like this. But we've also done macaroni and cheese in
a crock pot.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
So what we're going to do, we've made a cheese sauce instead mm-hmm. of cheese on the top. So what we're going to do is just top it with this breadcrumb and bacon topping, and you can serve it straight from your slow cooker if you want to, mm-hmm. or you can scoop it up and serve it in a dish. Either one is fine.
Okay.
But the key here is the cheese sauce, because you know, your creepy older brother takes the cheese all off the top.
And we want cheese all the way through this.
That's right. So we want cheese all the way through it, and instead of just a milk gravy, you've got a cheese mm-hmm. milk gravy for your macaroni. And then you don't have to use just elbow macaroni. You can see this one that I've used, a mini penne, and that's just is nice in there.
Okay,
so you don't have to just use elbow macaroni.
All right. Now tell me again, because I may have just missed it. How long does this cook in here?
Okay. Only a couple of hours on low. Okay. So what you're going to do is cook your pasta ahead of time,
mm-hmm.
make your cheese sauce, pour it over the top.
Okay.
And then when you get ready to top it, like we've done right here, then uncover the slow cooker.
So pour some in there. Let's see what that thing looks like.
I'll do it.
Ooh.
Doesn't it though?
Yeah.
Okay, so you've got a nice, see the cheese that's all through there? And this has got a mixture of fontina
mm-hmm.
and Gouda
okay.
and Parmesan in there. So see how
it's just
wonderful.
If that's my serving right there. But thank you. All right. Look for today's holiday cooking show recipes online at newschannel5.com.